brief was extensive and long. It included all sorts of very specific programmatic requirements, such as formal occasions, wreath laying. The stone, for example, for the paving had to take the weight of a tank. There were all sorts of really unusual considerations. But really the main one was that the work had to commemorate and represent the unique relationship between New Zealand and Australia as represented by the ANZAC Alliance. So the initial inspiration came from one of the Australian architects, and it was the Bungle Bungles in Western Australia, which is a really unique landscape formation. And that really started us on the journey of using stone, but we really landed on the idea of using columns, partly so that people could wander through and it become an experiential landscape, but also they could sort of symbolise a troop of men standing in a parade ground. We really tried to create something that was both immediate and timeless. We used red stone to symbolise the red continent of Australia, which is a really immediate and obvious thing. We also used a black granite to symbolise the, you know, very contrasting geography of New Zealand. The granite being a much harder stone was the opportunity to use that for the inscriptions, so commemorating all of the different countries and wars that the ANZAC Alliance has fought in, as well as some of the artwork of the Indigenous people. So one of the really challenging things we found was trying to get planting integrated into this quite sturdy landscape. Really, if there's ever an earthquake in Wellington, I would head for that place. There's quite a big concrete raft that supports all of these columns underneath there, and of course trying to get trees to grow in amongst concrete is not an easy thing to do. Quite a moving sense of pride, really. My dad came for the opening and he was intensely proud of my involvement in this, and I have a photograph of he and I standing at the front. So yeah, that was a really lovely thing. But also to see people walking in amongst the memorial, really sort of getting involved in it, that was something that I really felt quite strongly, that people should be able to meander through and look at some of the stories and get a sense of the enormity of what we're trying to put across. Thank you.